guys, now we will continue with the other looping statements, do while and for loop. Okay, so I will explain the syntax of this do while and for loop, right? So I will do one or two program with this do while and for loop. Otherwise, okay, I will explain other stuff also in the do while loop and for loop. There is no much difference between this do while and for loop. So here, okay, let us start with one small program in the do while. Okay, so here if I say int number equal to 1, 2, 3, if I want to perform some of the digits with this, okay, I do this only. I will do some of the digits for using this do while loop. So you have to complete other program as well. So we have a lot of programs using this. We can have Fibonacci series also. It's very, very important. Fibonacci series. Okay. And Armstrong number. To try to practice. So practice will make you perfect. Okay. Armstrong number. I will share this notepad in our group so that you will get to know about it. So I will explain the syntax first. What is do while? Okay, do. Then what is while? Okay. So here you need to write your statements. So here you need to write your statements. Then here you need to give your condition. Okay, so there is simple difference. The difference is, so initially you will give condition over here, then statement. So first it will complete the statement. So at any cost, it will execute at least one statement in the do while loop. Then if the condition is false, then it won't go inside the do while loop. Right? This is what the difference. So in this, in using while loop, where if the condition is true, it will go inside the while loop. Otherwise, this not at all, this while loop is not going to execute. So do while loop is at least one time the statement part will get executed. This while condition, which means anyhow, after completion of this execution of the statements, this while condition will check. If the condition is false, it won't. Right? So this is what the difference between while and do while. That not much much difference. Here if I say do, okay. So here one more thing is, when you use do while loop, here there must be one semicolon. We should be do while loop. This is the syntax. Okay. So instead of going with this, I equal to one. Here I want to give while measure equal to 10. Okay. So here if I say i value is, if I give i, now this will get executed. So it will start with the execution from I value is 1 up to 10 times it will execute. So you will get the result of we won't use much do while loop. Just understand the syntax. If it is possible, try to convert while to do while. We will not use much do while loop, but in case of while, you must know about it, because most of the time we will work with the for loop, because we have not included one part, that is increment part. So we have initialized the value, we have given the condition, but we have forget about the increment or decrement part. So we have given i++. So done as now. So you will get it now. So you will get now 1 to 10 values. Okay, so that's not much difference between while and do while. And we will go to for loop. this is a little different. So we are going to give initialization, condition, and agreement. It's going to be the same statement. This for loop is going to have three parts. One is initialization, then condition, then increment or decrement. Okay. Then you will write your statements. So you are going to have all the three inside your statements. Okay. So here you need to know how this for loop is going to execute here. Right. So initialization part will execute only one time. So this part will execute it at the first, and it's not going to execute any one of the time after initialization. So the first step, the condition will comes to the second. It will check the condition. Then the statement part will get executed the third. Then it will comes to the here increment or decrement. Again, it will check the condition. So this is the flow. Then again, it will comes to here six. So this will repeat again. It will repeat until the condition is false. Right. So first it will check the initialization. Then again it won't come. So it will check the condition. Then after checking the condition, if the condition is true, it will come to statement block. So the third statement. Then it will go for the increment or decrement. Then the fifth one is condition check. Okay. So this is what the flow of execution will be. It's not about your while. Also, when you say this is optional, then condition also optional, then increment decrement also optional. How we can say it is optional? When you declare the variable like I will remove this do while part. So when you select this part, so for when you do semicolon inside it, so it is considered as the optional. So I have not given initialization, I have not given condition also. This is very simple syntax about for. The if I want to do with the here if I say int, I will try to do with the factorial program using for loop so that you can able to convert other programs into for loop, right? So if I say int system is int, if I say I equal to 1, and then int I equal to 1. Then if I say system is started slow, so here no need to declare initialization anything before the for loop. So we can do everything inside the for loop only. So I can say here int I equal to 1. So I will do it later. So int I equal to 5, then I greater than equal to 1, then I say I minus minus. Okay, so you need to mention int I. So you say int I, so you can say fact equal to 1. Okay, so you can simply say fact equal to 5. Okay, so here you can directly print. Mm-hmm. factorial. You can directly print with the factor variable so that you will get the so always you remember the three parts, it's very important. So this is initialization, this is condition where, and the third part is increment or decrement. That will help you to achieve your. So now you have to practice lot of programs using this for loop, while loop, while loop, right? So what you have to do is you can go to Geek for Geeks, right? So there you can start do your programs in you can there are a lot of options in Geek for Geeks. There will be some levels. You can take the basic level using the, so you know now if, you know switch, you know for, then you know while, then you know now do while, right? So now you can start practicing. So you know they will give a problem statement, you need to write the program. Also when you register in Geek for Geeks, Geek for Geeks and one more site is there, I will share that, there also you can register. So there is a forum. So when you start practicing that, so you can able to solve the problems when you are appearing for the online test. If you give any online coding platform like so you can start practicing over there. That will help you to anyway, when you start practicing, you will start know about your improvement. So the continuous improvement will help you to add the interview. So this is basics. And if you have any doubt, do it just personally or in the group. I will try to solve your solution or result to solve your problem, right? So now the result is 120. The difference between the previous program, this program is, so the condition part came, where is it? Okay, this is our condition part, right? So the condition part came, so the condition part in the for loop is mid one, right? So increment or decrement part, this is the last part, okay? So that initialization part, it comes to the first part, right? So this is initialization, this is your condition, this is your increment or decrement. Now you can able to convert that, right? So this is the difference between your for, while and do while, right? So I think now you can able to solve this problem. Okay, guys, if you have any doubt, you can start now so that we can wind up the session. If you have any doubts till this session, tomorrow we will discuss about arrays. It's very, very important portion. So I'll try to cover a lot of programs using array, because there is a string, we need to reverse it, string, palindrome, and multiple things they will ask using string, right? So this is basic while do while. You are going to use the same concept in strings also, like string palindrome, string reverse, and there are multiple things are there. We'll cover it tomorrow using arrays. Then once we complete arrays, we'll go with the methods. So we'll start with static variable, static methods. Then we'll go for the object-oriented programming. I think we can able to start object-oriented programming from next week. I hope so. If it is possible, we'll start from next week object-oriented programming. Right? Guys, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, we can wind up. Any questions? Okay, I think you guys don't have any question. There's a chat box. No questions. Okay, thanks. Thank you guys. Thanks for joining. We'll join tomorrow. Thanks for joining.